Good morning, friends. Just wanted to touch base. So right now I'm reading through the book of Mark, and I'm reading through the book of Mark, and there's a word called exousia, and it means authority. It means power, and it's one of like five words that can be translated into power, but it means authority. And they use the word when Jesus is speaking to his disciples. He appointed the 12 apostles and is giving them authority, right? And I don't know why I thought exousia was an awesome name. Now, fast forward, there's times in the Bible that God has used people walking through something natural to produce something spiritual for his kingdom. Somebody once said, I think it was John Wesley, and it was a quote by Dr. Miles Monroe, quoting John Wesley, and he goes, without God, man cannot. Without man, God will not. How God is looking for someone to partner himself with. God is looking for faith to build something on. You know, people say faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things unseen. That is the Bible's definition, the recipe of miracles. And so in the Old Testament, you find people like, I think it was Isaiah and Elijah and Ezekiel. And throughout the Bible, you find people who are, Abraham, for example, God is asking them to do something in the natural so not knowing why, it seems so weird. Like, why? Why do you want me to sacrifice my son? Why do you want me to pour water on this wood, Elijah? Or why do you want me to, I think it was Ezekiel who had to like cook his food with human dung. And he was like, God, please, can we just use camel dung or something? He had to cook his food with that, right? And all of these things, God was looking for someone to stand in the gap. And again, without God, man cannot. Without man, God will not. He's choosing faith. He's choosing someone with faith. And so in scripture, time and time again, God is looking for someone to do something that doesn't make sense in the natural so they would have great spiritual breakthrough and application. Somebody said this to me. Nothing can happen in the spiritual. Nothing can happen in the natural until it happens in the spiritual. And I'm like, I don't know. I don't necessarily think that's all the way true. I think that sometimes it's true. But I think God uses people who walk through things and that their testimony is how he has breakthrough in the natural, right? So in the Old Testament there, I believe it's Hannah, who God is not walking. He's not speaking to the children of Israel. He is silent. He's not speaking to them. I want to say this is one of like maybe five times, maybe. And God is not speaking, doing anything in this season. There's a priest, Levi, but God is not speaking or moving on this country's behalf. And Hannah, who is a woman in a country where God is not speaking and speaking predominantly, historically, to men, right? Hannah is crying out and asking God for a son. She's barren. And again, not having a son in that culture at that point in time is like being poor. It's like being less than a woman. It's like being, you know, you name it. It's a type of shame. It's a type of shame. And so just being able to produce a son is like being able, you as a woman, has produced some type of like, it's like almost being patriotic to your lineage, to your family. You're giving your husband something to lean on and lean forward to, right? So you're giving your husband like a lineage, someone to carry on the family lineage, right? And carry on his name. So anyways, Hannah's crying out to God for a son while God is not answering that nation. So it kind of seems like counterintuitive. Why even try, right? And God may have you try something or attempt something in a season that everyone else is giving up, right? God may have you try something you failed at time and time again, time and time again. And so Hannah's crying out in the secret place. I want to say in the temple crying out day and night for a son. She's asking God for a son. And he answers her son. He answers her prayers. And her promise to God was, I will, if you give me a son, I will bring him, when he's of age, I will bring him to the Levites, to the priests, and he will grow up in your house, in your courts. And that's what she did. Her son, Samuel, was raised among the priests. And Samuel became a prophet to the nation of Israel. So God, the absence of God's voice, the one thing Hannah was crying out for, a son, she promised to dedicate that son to God's house, to his priesthood. And so Samuel, trained up by priest, is now a prophet, God's actual voice to a nation. So through the deficit of God not speaking, God uses Hannah's obedience and persistence to create his voice and begin to speak into a nation through her persistence. So the one thing where God was absent, he used her groaning, her travailing, to produce the one thing he wanted to do the entire time. God wanted to speak to Israel. Israel didn't want to speak to God. Again, without God, man cannot. Without man, God will not. And Hannah, a woman, right, latched her faith, called out for God, and God used that to produce a prophet to speak to a nation he loved but was very frustrated with. Abraham trusted God, and it was accredited to him as righteousness. Credit to him as righteousness, right? He trusted, he had faith in God, and it was credited to him as righteousness, to the point that he was willing to sacrifice his son. And his son yielded and submitted. The scripture background information says that Isaac was not a child. He was not just a small boy. He was almost just of age. He could have fought his dad, and he submitted to his father. And it was a foreshadow of Jesus going, let this cup pass from me. However, not my will, your will be done. And so Abraham put himself where he had to trust God and be obedient to God. And because Abraham trusted God, God had the opportunity to spare his son. A lot of us don't want to put ourselves in a situation where we have to even trust God. God, you want me to do what? I don't know. God's just looking for one person. Scripture says he searches the earth. He's searching. He's looking for someone that he can join, someone that has faith, that will stand with him and for him. Again, without God, man cannot do anything. But without God, without man, God will not. And so Abraham had the opportunity to see God provide a way out. And that's all God wanted to do, was provide a way out from the beginning and show him. Sometimes we just don't want to put ourselves in situations where we have to trust God. So with all that said, you may be walking through something and it doesn't make sense, but God may be using your anguish, your pain, your suffering, right? Paul, the Apostle Paul, his suffering helped move the church like forward. Him and his own body and the apostles with him help push the church forward and establish Christianity in the world single-handedly. I mean, this man was beaten and tossed and flogged. The flogging they gave Jesus, he got it like multiple times in dungeons. He was on house arrest, but then also a dungeon. Dungeon is a hole in the floor and they close it. That is a dungeon. They toss food through a hole, and I hope you get it. Hope he gets it before the rats do. That's a dungeon. But Paul was obedient in his suffering, allowed God to move. Same with, and I know in scripture you see a lot of Paul's writings, but we usually forget that Paul was like healing people and praying for people, and people got raised from the dead, you know? Time and time again, I'm trying to think other places in the Bible where God uses someone's persistence and obedience to create breakthrough in a nation. So again, what you're walking through, even though it's a test and you may feel like it is going to fall apart, just know God is going to use your life as a testimony to his goodness. Faith without works is dead. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. Take up the shield of faith. so that we can quench the fiery darts of the enemy. Right? God is looking for someone with faith. Faith is like a landing pad, and God to bring a miracle and breakthrough. Keep walking. Don't give up. Don't give in. I know it's hard. I know it's hard. But I love you, my friend, and God loves you more. Trust God.